Loneliness, being alone, the fear of being alone, is a huge part of what I am. At this great school that I was attending, the teacher on Valentine's Day said, everybody, send the people you like a Valentine. Everybody's going to get a Valentine. Some intuition, even as whatever I was, 6, 7, 8 years old, I sent myself Valentines, and those were the only Valentines I got. So that, why, I don't know.
Self-preservation, almost, I guess.
Well, that was the, for sending the Valentines. Why I didn't get any other Valentines remains the mystery.
Well, but in terms of that feeling of loneliness then, I guess it was a real fear that no one out there wanted to, you know, have a deeper connection with you.
Yes. Well, what is the connection, and how long does the connection last? What does the connection mean? How deep does the connection go? Can you depend on people being connected? What happens if you lose the connection? It has to do with love and security. And I'm of the illusion that everybody is lonely at one time or another, and some people more than others.
So if that's a hole that people get themselves into, yes. Have you figured out the way out?
Well, the way out is family and friends and participation in a variety of things, a show, a movie, a work, a charity, helping other people, training animals and being part of a larger, I mean, the whole human race is divided into units to deceive loneliness, from the family unit to the tribe to the nation to the union of the EU and the, I mean, it just goes on, a collection of joining in order to avoid loneliness, otherwise you won't be alone.
You make it sound like a lifetime battle for people.
Well, it is. Every major episode of your life is tearing away from what you thought was permanent. And there's no permanence. Change is the nature of the universe, and everything is changing. And can we accept that change? And you look at that change and think, my God, I'm moving my house. I'm moving to another area. I'm going someplace else. Somebody just died. What do I do? It's if you look at your life, it's constantly changing and evolving to something. And those connections that you had, you no longer have. And for me, it's like, wow. I think deep down we're all lonely. I think deep down we understand that we're born alone and we die alone. And that dying alone is, as you get older, becomes more and more a subject of thought. What happens? And that's where I'm at.
If someone out there is watching this and feels lonely, what's your advice to them?
Go into a bar and slap somebody on the shoulder.
Just not you.
Do something for somebody. That's my advice. That's what I would do. Do something for somebody else. And I think, for me, that's a way of avoiding or overcoming loneliness.
Hello, I'm Liz Hayes. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9 Now app for full episodes and other exclusive 60 Minutes content.